We're here to talk about Jesus Christ and Him crucified. We're here to win the lost to the Lord, and we're here to lift up the body of Christ that we may go higher in the Lord and we become greater in the image of Christ. The Bible says God's will for us is to conform us to the image of Christ. So it's not just like those hyper grace channels, hyper grace people who believe you say the sinner's prayer and then go live like hell the rest of your life. God wants us to be sanctified. He wants us to come out from among them and be holy, for I am holy. Without holiness, no man will see God. That's what Peter said. The Lord wants us to be conformed to the image of Christ. And so I can't be conformed to the image of Christ if I'm chain smoking cigarettes, I'm drinking booze, if I'm looking at pornography, if I'm living with someone I'm not married to, I'm not being conformed to the image of Christ. So whatever you're doing, you need to repent of it, which we are called to repentance, brothers and sisters. Paul tells us in the book of Acts, God calls all men everywhere to repent. Turn from our ways, brothers and sisters. There's the mental agreement that Jesus is the Christ. He died on the cross for us. Then there's also repenting, turning from your wicked ways. Many, many Bible verses. Acts chapter 3, Peter said, repent ye therefore and be converted that your sins may be blotted out. That word converted is turn from your ways. Repent is to change your mind and believe on Jesus Christ and turn from your ways. 1 John 1:9, Jesus is telling us in 1 John 1:9, if we confess our sins, see, that's repent, not thinking about it. If we confess our sins, he is just and faithful to forgive us of our sins and cleanse us of all unrighteousness. The Lord told the woman caught in adultery, go and sin no more, brothers and sisters. He didn't say, well, by my grace, you have a license to do whatever you want to. Go back to what you were doing. You don't have to become a new creature. No, the Bible says when we get saved, we become a new creature in Christ. The old man has passed away. That's what water baptism is all about, brothers and sisters. That we're buried with Christ and raised with him. Paul said, I die daily. It's not I who lives, but Christ who lives within me. Galatians 2:20. You know, in another verse, Paul said, you know, the great mystery, Christ within us, the hope of glory. Hallelujah. Praise God. So either you are on the throne of your heart, the devil's on the throne of your heart, or Jesus Christ is on the throne of your heart. That's it. So either there could be, you could have idols too. I just thought about it. I know a brother, supposed to be a brother, whose wife is his God. And she is literally his God. And he struggles with it all the time, but he has not repented of it. He knows it, confesses it, but still does it. His wife is his idol, his God. She's on the throne of his heart. Lots of people like that. I meet lots of supposed to be brothers and sisters in Christ whose husband or wife, maybe even their children or whatever, is their on the throne of their heart. Some people, it's even a pet. There are people today in America, first world problems, they have pets on the throne of their heart. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ and him crucified. It's all about Jesus. Put all your faith and trust in Lord Jesus Christ tonight. He should be seated on the throne of your heart. The Bible says Romans 8, those who are led by the Spirit, these are the children of God. So if I'm being led by my wife, then I'm not a child of God. I'm a child of her. If I'm being led by Mama Mary, or if I'm led by something I saw on television, or if I'm led by Donald Trump, if I'm led by Joe Biden, then I'm a son of Joe Biden or a son of Donald Trump or whatever. But those who are led by the Spirit of God, these are the children of God. It's like Jesus told the Pharisees in the temple in John chapter 8. They said they were children of Abraham. Jesus said, if you were children of Abraham, you would do the works of Abraham. See? Listen to that. Jesus said, if you were children of Abraham, you would do the works of Abraham. So if you're a child of God, you'll do the works that God did. Godliness, holiness, like I talked about. Peter gave us that is the fifth level of what we're to add to our faith. 2 Peter chapter 1, godliness. That is to be godlike, to be conformed to the image of Christ. Not to be living in sin, but loving our neighbor as ourselves and all those things, right? To be godlike is not getting drunk. You know, it's visiting your neighbor when they're in the hospital and praying for people or whatever and all those things, like what the Lord did, what the disciples did. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. Praise God tonight. Hallelujah. I could go on and on with all these things, brothers and sisters, as the Lord leads. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. God is good, brothers and sisters. So Jesus told them who their father was. He said, you're of your father, the devil, because he was a liar and the father thereof. So Jesus was saying, because you're lying and saying that they told Jesus, why did Jesus say that? Because they called him illegitimate. They called him a Samaritan. They said, weren't we right when we said that your father is a Samaritan and you're demon possessed? You know, they even asked him, who is your father? Jesus said, no one knows the father except me. And they're like, well, who is your father? So they're saying he's illegitimate. They were saying he's half, half Jewish, half Samaritan. And he was demon possessed. That's what they said to Jesus. You're a demon possessed bastard. That's what they told Jesus. Can you imagine? You talk about blasphemy. That's what they said to Jesus' face. That's why he said, you're of your father, the devil. He's a liar. See, they were lying. He's a liar from the beginning and the father thereof. So see, out of their own mouth, they were lying about him and blaspheming. So there are people today that I talk to all the time. I've got neighbors. They say they're Christians, but every word out of their mouth is blasphemy. And they get drunk all the time and they're blaspheming. And tell me, oh, yeah, well, you can believe what you want, but I believe once saved, always saved. You believe whatever you want to believe. Between chain smoking them cigarettes and drinking all the time and blaspheming every other word. When I read the Bible, just this one text we're talking about, Jesus said, you are the father of what's coming out of you. If you were a child of Abraham, you'd be doing what Abraham did. If you're a child of the devil, you do what the devil did. So if you're doing what the devil did, then who is your father? It's just so simple, brothers and sisters. There's 1,000 Bible verses, and I talk about them all the time. This is a whole nother Bible reference to it. We are called to be separated, brothers and sisters, sanctified.